If you face blindness and it starts to seem as though your eyes are only good for crying and you're feeling all alone, come to a place of kindness and in a new way you will see that there's much more to hope than just learning to cope. You can live a life that's full and free. We're the Vision Resource Center. Let us be your guiding light as we strive to keep your dreams alive. Even if you lose your sight, you're not alone. Pick up the phone. We help friends and family too. We're the Vision Resource Center for people affected by blindness and low vision. We're here for you.
Good morning and welcome to the December episode of Insight here on BCTV. My name is Mark Levengood, counselor at the Vision Resource Center, and we would like to welcome all of our guests who are tuning in today. We'd like to also thank our sponsor, the Low Vision Therapy Program of Health Calls. Our topic for this morning as we go into the holiday season is indeed how the visually impaired experience and celebrate the holiday season, what it's like for them in comparison to the sighted community. My colleague Alicia Santiago is my guest today. And good morning, Alicia. How are you?
Good morning, Mark. I'm fine, and you?
I'm well, thank you. So, Alicia, why don't we start right off? What changes did you see in your holiday season experiences since you lost your vision?
I did tell you, I'm not sure if you've chosen the right person. if you talk about visual sightness, I would say yes, it has changed a lot. However, there's a lot of things that you could incorporate to make it work for you.
Okay.
For example, if we take the holidays, for say, we take Easter.
Mm-hmm.
I love doing it.
Okay.
Because I'm not a blind person. Really, I'm just a person who gets away with a lot of things because I could play with the kids looking, hunting for the eggs.
Right.
A lot of people, older people, don't do that because I look stupid.
Okay.
Like, I care, really.
Right, right.
But the other holidays, I enjoy them because it's with family, friends, like 4th of July, I love the food.
Okay. So from your perspective, there's not any one annual holiday that is best for the visually impaired in terms of, you know, being able to participate and not feel left out.
If you really think about the visual part as the fireworks, things like that, you would say yes. But I had the experience of a friend years ago let me shoot one of those little things, and it was kind of fun. He said, I won't let you do it too much, but he let me do it, and it was really
sure.
interesting. And and I got the chance to feel how it is when you turn the match and do the seeing
what
it,
it's like,
not really.
Okay.
You know, but describe, you always have to have someone, a friend, a family, someone who really describes the thing that you just have to go into them to see it.
Right. So really, the visually impaired can experience any holiday in the calendar year.
Yes.
Maybe just a little adaptation or some assistance.
And enjoy it. Okay. Yes, it's going to be sometimes, like you earlier we talked about,
right,
that it might be depressing, but not really.
Right. Okay.
Just make it for you.
Yeah.
Make it for you.
Well, a lot of people during this Christmas and New Year season oftentimes experience what are known as the holiday blues. Do you think holiday blues occur for the visually impaired community? And if so, why do you think that is?
I think happens to everyone.
Okay.
You are blind or you are not. Doesn't matter for the disabled community, for anyone, because you think about past.
Mm-hmm.
And what you did a couple of years ago, what you did last year, could it be better this year?
Okay.
So holiday blues doesn't just be for a blind person. For me, it will happen to everyone.
So really, it has nothing to do with sight. It's all about past experiences and
memories. For you, if you think back when you were little, or you had fun when you open a present, and do you know what I mean?
Right.
You still do. You still get fun opening a present because you're like, I wonder what they got me this time.
Yeah.
You know?
So as we go into this upcoming holiday winter season, how could, in your opinion, the sighted community be more sensitive to the visually impaired community, specifically your sighted family and friends?
I'm blessed because I have acquired really good friends, really good acquaintance, really good family, most of them, where they give me... One of the things that is wonderful is gift cards. If you want to give us a blind person, give them gift cards. Take them to the store. Let them loose. You know how they let loose kids? Let us loose, you know? We could purchase what we want. Right now, years ago, it's just what to get them. But right now, with the gift cards, are wonderful.
Right.
If for you and I, it is completely different because you and I like to experience how this feels. So a lot of tactile. There's a lot of things that could turn into being tactile, you know, presence.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? It could be adopted. You could just make it for you. Again, this is all gifts for a blind person, a person who is visually impaired. They could be could be turned into a way they could use it. You just have to be, you know, think as that person. I would think, why can't I get you that you will enjoy it?
Right.
Yes, you could get a sweater, a nice sweater.
Mm-hmm.
However, that will get you a sweater that they see you for 5 miles away. I don't want that sweater. You know, those colors are like neon signs. I don't want those.
Right.
But they, you know, the feel of the sweater.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? The feel of the blouse or the shirt. It's always, think always tactile.
Okay.
Tactile.
Okay. So since losing your sight, what would you say is the most difficult part or aspect of the holiday season for you?
See, there you go for me again. I enjoy every season because every season has something to give. Christmas, again, I love the fall. Everything is pumpkin. This is my year to eat everything pumpkin. January comes and I just forget about it.
Right.
But the smells, every season has a smell, and right now everything is so frosty, toasty, smelly, pies.
Deliciousness.
Oh, hello.
Okay.
It's just really enjoying the smells, enjoying the, I like I said, please, adjusting. You never get used to being blind, but you adjust to that situation.
Sure.
So using all your other senses, if you are capable of doing it, is wonderful for these holidays because you're enjoying it. I have been to parties with friends and I could tell you which person is drunk. Which person is not. I will tell you, sometimes my friend missed things because I go, didn't you see that person getting drunk and all stumble? And I go, who? And I go over there at the corner. What you see in the middle with it in the corner? The wall is holding them. They're not holding the wall.
Right.
And they're like, how do you notice this thing? I say, because I need to know where to get out and when to get in.
Right.
And little things like that, but I do that all the time. You do that all the
time. Sure,
yeah. It's just enjoying the moment because... the lack of sight.
Right.
I think for me.
You started to touch upon this with all the pumpkin and the pies and the frosty smells and so forth, but since you lost your sight, have you found any joy in new parts of the holiday season? You know, any things that were overlooked that when you had sight that, you know, are kind of like new discoveries, newfound points of joy? And if you have, could you explain that? Explain that new
due to
joy.
When I was younger, my sight was limited. So a lot of the things, again, I had to lose my hearing and the little vision I had and the tactile.
Right.
Now I cut it to just tactile and hearing.
Mm-hmm.
And in the other day, I got a train. You would say, why? And I just laid down and listened to the train.
Uh-huh.
And I kept saying, something is missing.
Right.
Because you're looking at it and it's supposed to throw a little smoke, so it was missing something.
Okay.
And I go, this is missing something. And my family member said, oh, it's missing the thing to throw smoke. I said, you better put something in there, because that needs the, you know, the whole nine yards.
Right.
And I think a lot of time is the little things that always gets to miss. Mm-hmm. And us being blind, we could listen to it. We could really be more in tune to what it is. You
sure.
know, the blinking lights. They do have that little sound if you really pay attention when they
okay,
turn
yeah.
on. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
you have
yep.
noticed that, and before you just look, oh, they look pretty.
Sure.
But then you could really.
You can hear it.
You can hear it. And again, I'm not saying that my hearing and Mark's hearing has become more. No, what it is him and I pay attention.
Yeah.
Him and I are more in tune with our surroundings.
Use it to the greater potential.
Exactly. Yeah. And everyone has the same hearing, I mean, to the levels. But, I mean, Mark's mom or my mom could do the same. It's, mm-hmm. it's just, we just use it more.
Right. So in light of everything you just said there about, mm-hmm. you know, these little things that you're picking up on and, you know, paying attention to the detail now that you don't have sight, would mm-hmm. you say that your blindness and your visual impairment has actually enhanced or detracted from your holiday experiences?
I would say both.
Yeah.
Because you do need sights to notice really beautiful things.
Uh-huh.
Again, this brings me a story. Years ago, I grew up in New York, and one of the best things in New York is a Rockettes.
Yes.
And you have to have vision to see see the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
However, I got the chance to touch the costumes.
Okay.
The different sizes. And then someone, you know, just the different costumes, what mm-hmm. they were going to wear. And then someone showed me what is it they do. You know, the little dances and steps and
right.
all that. And I put all those things together and visualize it. How would it look and the person on me if I was one of the Rockettes
mm-hmm.
and do the, you know, the dances and the act they do.
Right.
And for me, again, for me, it was gratifying.
Right,
because
sure.
I seen it in my mind,
mm-hmm.
touching what the costumes were, the colors. Well, someone told me this is glittery, this is this color, this
right.
is what color.
Right.
And you just come up. If you would say a blind person who never seen colors, again, do the tactile.
Right, you can feel the glittery.
Exactly,
yeah.
in the imagination, visualizing someone's, even on yourself, on, I will look stupid on there. Darn,
right.
I will look really nice on that too.
Sure.
But it really depends on you.
And
a lot of the times is the experience of the holiday, especially this one, if we think about back into your question of the blues,
mm-hmm.
is what you make it for yourself.
Okay.
For me, I'm trying to enjoy it as much as I'm able without sight.
Right.
Would
so
I
make
miss
it,
things? Yes.
You make it what you want.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. So much of this time of year has become commercialized with gift giving and so forth. So I'm
all
curious,
for that.
Well, how do you do your holiday shopping? How do you actually go out to buy your Christmas gifts?
Well, as I said earlier, if I'm going to get you a sweater, I just need to know your sight, your personality.
Right.
If you really care for that person, or it's just someone you just met, you want to make sure, for me, if I just met that person, I want to make sure to give him something nice
mm-hmm.
because it's what I would like to be given to myself.
Mm-hmm.
You always think of how can this person, and sometimes it's difficult because people are so, you don't know exactly what to give them, that's why you get them a gift card.
Right.
A lot of the things is looking online.
This, okay.
If you don't have the capability or the accessibility you online, a lot of their different companies, you know, stores have mm-hmm. 1-800 numbers.
Right.
If they have wonderful salespeople,
okay.
you could tell them, I'm visually impaired, I'm blind, I would really love to use your eyes.
Okay.
When you really put it in that sense, you know,
right.
they will like, oh,
they
okay,
help
they help
so,
you.
So since you can't drive to the store, you either do online shopping or you call the 1-800 number and kind of go through their sales marketing people.
See, there you go. I don't drive myself to the store. Hello, I told you before. Your mama leaves the key next to me, car will go so far.
Well, assuming that that key isn't left there, I guess.
Exactly, assuming. But it is the fun of really always getting someone, did you care about something nice and simple?
Right. So you find a way to do it.
Exactly. Like cards, Christmas cards years ago, they didn't have Braille on them. Now.
Right, now a lot of them do.
Yes, they do. Yeah. They have those little music things. Yep. I love those little things.
Yeah, you open it up and it's all musical.
Exactly. Yeah. So there's a lot of things you could really create your mind to give for that person to enjoy the holidays.
Right.
Who is non-sighted, who's sighted, who's visually impaired. It's just making it that holiday to be enjoyable.
Right. So since you lost your vision, do your friends and family say that you're easy to buy gifts for or difficult to buy gifts for?
Well, they know as long as they feed me, I'm happy.
Okay. So for you, the best gifts would be food.
Well, hello. Except chocolate, but everything. Yes, I know, ladies, you gotta have chocolate, but in this case, darn it, can't. But my friends, as well as I do for them, they will really think of tactiles, because I have been shopping with them. They always describe things for me. They always will tell me, would you like this? Do you know those little things, those glow things that you remember when you were little and you shake them and snow? I love those little things. I love the music they have. The only thing is, do you know what I mean? For me to touch them, you have to break them apart and see them inside. But years ago, I have this friend who gave me a couple because she knows I love the music and it was different music. And then she described the scenery in the glow.
Right.
Now, then I got nieces and those little things went out of the window, you know, they become nothing because they pick them up and broke them. But that's the best thing. I have another friend, she travels a lot and she brings pictures. And I always ask her, please, she said, what can I bring? I said, bring me your memories. Why? Now she goes to whatever country she decides to go. I think she recently went to Morocco. She described the whole thing to me. I could see it through her eyes.
Right.
And she had the pictures. She was able to describe them to me.
So that was a gift for you, just because it was like you were on that trip.
Exactly. Because that's the person
you have. Through her.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And I think that's one thing, please, sighted people, if you have someone visually impaired, give them the gift of you, which means describe things to them as you will see them. If they don't understand it, find a way to tactile them.
To bring it to them so they do understand it.
Enjoy. I mean, I love the trees. If the trees is a natural, you know, the Christmas tree, I love the smell. Not in my house, but...
Right.
It's just the smell. Let them touch the little figurines. Let them touch and describe. I love doing that.
Okay.
Oh, especially when they do the candy cane.
Yes.
You know, when they let me touch it, a couple of those will be missing, but hello, they know already that. So they
get it. So thinking about this now, you've mentioned some of it with what you've already said, but what are some of the best gifts and the worst gifts you've received since you lost your sight?
That neon sign.
That neon sweater.
Sweater. But you know what I did? I said, okay, I wear it with the person.
Right.
And they said, Alicia, they could see us. I go, exactly.
Right.
So I go, oh, don't wear that again. I go, you got that right. But I didn't say to that person, oh, I don't like it.
Sure.
Because for me, it's unpolite to do that.
Right.
A lot of my friends give me, I love lotions as a normal female. I love things that I could use. And they do that.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know, they give me... I love PJs, pajamas with cartoons on them, and that's because my nieces. Do I lose them after? Yes, because my nieces, even though they're in their 20s, 19s, teens, they still like those things.
Mm-hmm.
But when I give them gift, I already know which of them what they like.
Right.
And I hit the mark a lot of the times because it's something I will buy for myself. I will know they will like it.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say I don't call it a bad gift. I don't call it a good gift. I call it an enjoyable gift.
Okay. That's a good way
Again,
to say that.
Again, give out gift cards. Hello.
Well, and I was just going to go there next. Like, mm-hmm. for visually impaired people in general, I know you've said gift cards. Mm-hmm. Like, what genre or type of gift is best? You know, genres being clothing, assistive or adaptive equipment,
all of that is
personal,
great.
Personal entertainment devices.
I mean, as you know, there's a lot of devices that we could use. Mm-hmm. Just needs to be accessible, you know.
Right.
Make it what, gift cards, you could go yourself and purchase something you really want at that store.
Right.
I think the difficult is when you give a gift card, please set up a date. I don't know, January 15, I'm going to take you to that store. This is a gift card for such a store, and I will take you to that store January 15 to are you available that day
right.
to take you, and you purchase the amount on which you have your gift
card. So don't just give the gift card, but actually make a date to go with it,
and
to
I
actually
think
go
that's
and use
part
it.
Of the gift.
And is the time together that goes with it.
And exactly.
Yeah.
Because then you pick what you want
with that person.
With that person. Okay. Or with someone else, but at least you get that chance to do it yourself.
Right.
Again, if you don't have someone to take you, give us a call, give us the gift card, we get you something.
So it's the gift of the card and what you get with the card, but also then the gift of time with
exactly.
the person.
Yeah. I think that's a lot of the times sighted people feel, what can I do for that person sitting, playing cards, doing things? And yes, we could play cards. We could cheat on cards. I teach you that later work. We could do a lot of things that, yes, might not be for a sighted person. How can this blind person do that? There's
right.
a lot of things you and I know that we could do. Yes, there's others we cannot. But to make it gift-giving, holiday, enjoyment, all that, food,
mm-hmm.
if the person has diabetes, make sure that the food is diabetes.
Or any food restrictions.
Exactly, and we don't want them to say,
right.
you know, we heard it from Mark and Alicia,
right.
no,
yeah.
I'm just saying.
Like, you can't do chocolate, I can't do dairy.
Exactly.
So take that into consideration.
Exactly,
yeah.
So it's just little things like that. I think the enjoyment of the holidays is what you make it.
Mm-hmm.
If you have people surrounding you, or even your neighbor, that just, what can I give you?
Yeah.
You could give me anything as long as you're giving it to me with joy.
Right.
And I enjoy it by you receiving it from you.
Yeah.
I mean, and you said about adaptive devices. Yes, there's all these different games that are adapted for the blind. The difficulty is they cost a lot.
Yes.
There's a way to make those same normal games to be adapted to a blind person,
yeah.
to make it enjoyable.
To just buy it off the normal store shelf and adapt it yourself, as
yeah.
opposed to spending four times
yeah.
as much for this type.
I
of
played
yeah.
with cards.
Right.
They just needed to be borrowed.
Mm-hmm.
I play with table games. You know, I'm sorry, I'm going to mention one, Monopoly.
Right.
It costs too much to purchase one, but I had a wonderful friend who said, a family member, and we brailled it, because it was for me, so
mm-hmm.
I adjusted it to myself. Not that I wrote everything, but I knew what the card was, because you made it for you.
Sure.
You know? And but, you know, I have family members and friends that are cheaters, so they wanted to cheat me with the money.
Right.
That was the hard part, but
yeah.
I got them. You know? But it's just the enjoyment of enjoying, especially now with the winter days.
Right.
You know? It's like, let's do something.
Yeah.
The electronic games is, it's just a lot of games that it could be adjusted for a kid who's willing to, you know, teach him, sit there
mm-hmm.
with that kid. You know, that's quality time. If you sit with that kid who's blind and you could teach him how to play that game, you have to have the patience and the time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a time to give, you
right.
know? Okay, move it this way, move it that way.
Right.
Go this way, go that way. Oops, you hit the wall. Darn it, it
yeah.
gives you that noise. But is what you do, that giving time of you to that person,
mm-hmm.
that it really sometimes is the most valuable for me.
Sure. So in closing,
mm-hmm.
What would be some advice you would suggest to the sighted people, especially those who have visually impaired family and friends, to take into consideration and not overlook this holiday season? And likewise, what advice would you give to the visually impaired as we go into this time of year so that both parties can fully enjoy the holiday season to the fullest extent?
You don't blame a lot, and we do that, and I'm sorry, and Mark, we blame the sighted without saying that I'm saying. What I'm saying is I'm not just telling them I blame you for having vision and I feel bad because I don't have it.
Mm-hmm.
No. Don't blame that person to have vision, do you know what I mean? To be sighted.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Because you spilled something, you did something. No. Try to adjust whatever sight you have, if you don't have any, to your way of doing things. The sighted person, don't feel bad, because
sure.
It's not your fault that person lost her vision.
Mm-hmm.
There are ways for you to help them. There are ways for them to enjoy the holiday. There are ways for them to enjoy the gift.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing that you need to do as a sighted person is think as a blind person, and be, when you don't turn on the light from the bedroom to the bathroom, you are blind as Mark and I are. It's just you don't realize you're doing it because you're half asleep.
Right.
It's like 98% you're half asleep. And then you do it without knowing you're doing it. Walking from the kitchen to the bedroom, from the bedroom to the kitchen, and you'll be turning off the lights because you know. So the only difference is you and I live in that.
Right, they can turn the lights on.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So think as a blind person will think, and it makes it easier on the person who's blind, on the person who's sighted. Things would be easier. Don't feel, I'm not sure what word I'm looking for here, but it's just, it's sometimes more difficult for a sighted person to keep saying to themselves, I don't know how to help you. Ask
right.
me.
Yeah.
Right?
Always ask.
Yeah.
Yep.
If you don't know, call us.
Yep.
We will tell you. Right? We will make you a list on blog, print, whatever way you want it. We will make it. But enjoy yourselves as giving,
right.
You know, and you will receive so much.
Yeah.
That will, especially this time of year.
Mm-hmm.
For me, this time of year is every whole year. Because, come on, the food. Hello.
And on that happy note, we thank you, Alicia, for joining us today on Insight and kind of giving some insight, indeed, shedding some light on what it's like to go through the holidays with a visual impairment and to help our sighted community who have visually impaired friends and family to know how to help and support them during this time of year. We do hope that our viewers enjoyed this today. And once again, we thank our sponsor, the Low Vision Therapy Program from Health Calls. Just a heads up for an upcoming event on December the 16th, the Vision Resource Center will be having our annual Christmas party from 11 to 2 at the agency, and there will be a raffle, a catered meal, and a one-hour performance by Elvis Presley himself.
Hey, that's so cool.
If anyone is interested in coming, please call me at 610-375-8407, extension 120, by December the 9th to register. And
this is for everyone, not just for the visually impaired.
Well,
please.
It's for the visually impaired and family of the visually impaired.
Yeah.
So it's not just all of Redding and Berks County is invited.
I know.
No.
If all of Redding wants to come, you better bring some presents.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
So it is for the visually impaired
and
their families.
And then everybody. Doesn't mean you're not with the agency. No. Just call Mark and you'll be able to attend. Have a nice time with a bunch of us.
So, and then we're doing a charity gift that day for Berks Women in Crisis. So if you choose to come, just bring a gift to support those in need. So with that, we thank you once again tuning in. And we wish you a very happy and blessed holiday season. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and we will see you in January 2016. Have a great day.
Insight on BCTV is supported by Low Vision Works by Health Calls.